Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. Glad to be back with you, and I'm so happy I've got my friend back, Susan. She's going to talk about a fantastic topic. But before, I would like to introduce Susan Erickson. So Susan lives in Iowa in the States, and she likes to travel, garden, try new things, sunshine, the beach, laughter of good friends, and a good glass of wine. Susan is a mindset abundance coach, and her passion is to help women live abundantly. She's also the owner and CEO of Holistic Institute of Wellness. She has worked with many different styles, personalities, ethnicities, religions, and backgrounds, always providing a safe space for her clients to cultivate their path and accomplish their goals. All of these experiences and values allow her to be the coach that will help you create progress with gentleness and grace, moving your clients forward with perseverance and integrity. It is a mission to guide you in discerning your purpose and calling. That's what will guide you back to your authentic self. And welcome, Susan. And today, you're going to talk to us about the empowered mindset. So thank you for being here again. It's always a pleasure to have you on board and to have you with us on the Isabelle Talk Show. And let us know what it is an empowered mindset. Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, Isabelle, first of all, for having me here today. I always enjoy our talks so much. And the fact that we can be in totally opposite places in the world and still be able to have a conversation and still be able to talk and to help people and to live our passion is just like, it's so amazing to me that we get to be blessed enough to do that. So thank you so much for having me today.
You're welcome.
And yes, I wanted to talk about empowered mindset. As an abundance coach, I'm all about mindset, right? I think everything we do starts with our mindset. That's not all it takes, right? But that's where we have to start, because if we don't have the right mindset, all of the other work that we do can't get us as far as we absolutely can go. It can't get it to our absolute best unless we also have the right mindset. So all of the hard work we do can only get us so far. All of the schooling that we have, or all of the upbringing that we have, all of the things that we do, all of the hard work that we put in can only get us so far if we don't have the right mindset, if we're not open to receiving all of those things that are there and available for us, and realizing all of the things that we already have within us. And so as an empowered mindset, as a piece of abundance mindset, and I think this is especially true for women. It's not only women. I mean, men do too, but I think especially women struggle with that empowered mindset. Now, the dictionary describes it as the process of becoming stronger and more confident, especially in controlling one's life and claiming one's own rights. So when you think about that, and again, particularly for females in many parts of the world, that our own rights are not always the same as they are sometimes legally, but sometimes even just sort of subversively, they're not the same, right? And even right here in the US, in my lifetime, that it's become possible for women to get a bank loan, a home loan in their own name. You know, prior to 1970 something, that wasn't possible. Like, a woman had to have a male sign with her. So just things like that, that would prevent women from potentially owning their own business or owning their own home, and from having that sort of empowered mindset so that we believe that we can do that. You have to believe that you can do it and that you can have it before you can actually get there. And so having that empowered mindset brings us that clarity, that focus, to reach our goals, to get what we rightfully deserve and want in life, for ourselves and for those around us. I fully believe as an abundance coach, when we raise up our own energy level, when we are standing in our power, that just raises up everyone around us, right? I mean, stop and think about it. When you're around someone who is like that, don't you feel more empowered? Don't you feel more confident when you're in that space?
You can even feel the energy.
Right? Yes, absolutely. You can feel that energy. And that when I'm talking about being confident, I'm not talking about somebody that walks in and necessarily owns the room and is loud and outgoing. And that can be, you can be that if that is your nature and you're confident, but you can be just as confident and be quiet and still control the room, right? And still maintain that level of confidence. It's all about the energy that you bring, the energy that you bring to the space that you are in, because it shows. It shows also, when you're empowered.
Yes.
And it feels when you're empowered, right? So just think about that. Can you think about someone in your life that you recall that brought that to you, to your space? And if it's not somebody in your personal life, is there someone like a celebrity or somebody, someone that was famous, like an author or someone like that, that you know, that you think of when you think of having someone empowered, that shows that empowerment, that brings that level of confidence?
Well, for me, I like Richard Branson, for example.
Oh, yes.
I like him Richard because he started from scratch, you know, he didn't actually go to university, and look where he is now.
Yeah.
But he's got that confidence, but not like be bragging about it. You know, he's got that confidence, but including others to rise with him. And that's what I like.
I am so glad that you said that, Isabelle, because one of the big qualities about empowerment is inclusivity. So when we feel empowered, we are inclusive of others. So we have to feel that ourselves, mm-hmm. Oftentimes, in order for us to reach out and to be inclusive in of others. But if we are inclusive of others, it's because we are feeling confident in ourselves, right? Yeah.
There's no competition.
There's no competition. There's no scarcity.
Exactly.
There's no scarcity. It's a total abundance mindset to have that inclusivity of others. And so I wanted to just share with you a little way to be able to do that. If you're feeling maybe a little less confident walking into maybe a meeting or a group that you don't know, or maybe you walk into a room and you don't know anybody there and they're all totally different than you and all of that. And then what do? Right. You feel really uncomfortable and probably not confident. And so to be able to just, first of all, be in the moment, right. That's one of the, another really big thing about being in an abundant lifestyle is to live in the moment, to be fully present in the moment. So just, I would invite you, if that happens, to just be fully present in that moment. And then to look at being inclusive. So how do I do that when I'm not feeling like I know anybody or know anything about them, right? Well, we can physically do that in order to help ourselves mentally do that. Right? So we can do that with taking a look at where we're at, because what happens when we feel like we're not confident, when we feel less than self-confident, right? When our self-confidence level is low, what happens?
Well, we just stay inside ourselves. We don't actually go out. We just stay in the corner, look around. Sometimes wishing that people would not see us. So.
Yes. Yes, right? Yeah, we get closed in. We kind of put up a defensive shield. Maybe we try to shrink down and not be seen. We try to put up our protection, right, around us. And we're not inclusive that way. We can't be, and we're not confident that way. So in order to sort of work against that and to be very intentional about it, so that we're not in that feeling like that, so that we can feel more confident, we feel more empowered. First of all, is just to stand up, right? And to put our shoulders back, to be breathing deep, to have that deep breathing, and because that is something we always can control, is our breath, right? Of all of the bodily functions that we have, many of them we can't control. We can't control our heartbeat, right? We don't control that when it happens. We don't control our blood flow, but we can control our breath. And so that gives us, again, that feeling of I'm in control. I can control my breath. And then to take a look, use your vision to give you an inclusive feeling, right? So if you're in a room, whether it's large or small, if you're in a room and you're feeling not confident, take a look out in front of you, about 3 feet, first of all, right? And see what's in that field of vision, okay? And maybe you notice there's people in there, maybe there's not. Maybe you notice what the room looks like at that point. Maybe you notice that it's really hot in here, or it's really cold in here. And then take a look a little farther out, right? What do you see? When you look up, what do you see? Do you see a sea of people? Do you see a few faces that you know or no faces that you know? What do you see? And then take a look to the farthest corner of the room. Look around, and what do you see? And make a really mental note of that. What do I see? I see somebody that's maybe dressed like me, maybe they're not dressed like me, but I see somebody that has hair like me, or hair like somebody else I knew, or maybe they have eyes like that, maybe they have glasses like that, right? Maybe they're speaking a totally different language and look totally different, but you will always find something that you have in common. And if you don't, I would invite you to go up and just speak to that person, to any of the people, and say, you know, and introduce yourself. The whole idea of that 7 degrees of separation, have you heard yeah. about that? There's a book about that. And I know many people will say, I think it's only 4 or 5 at the most, right? Because it doesn't matter where I go, that there's always somebody that you will find that you have something in common with.
And sometimes you don't realize, but what you're saying is like having a look and somebody will make contact, eye contact, without even, you know, planning it. So yeah. That could be the person to go and talk to.
Absolutely, right? That could be the person, for some reason, whatever it was, that you felt that connection, that they felt that connection.
Exactly.
They absolutely did, for that to happen. And again, connections are all happen all the time, as long as we're open to that and we're open to receiving that, to hearing it, to feeling it, whatever that is. I took a trip to India a couple of years ago, and I stayed at an ashram, and we had a day there of where we had a workshop, and somebody came in and translated for the women who spoke Hindu, and then the speaker actually spoke English. But then afterwards, like, everyone was just mingling together, all of these women in their traditional dress. And one of the women who lived in a little home, she was a teacher and lived in a little home in the ashram, invited us to her home. And so we went over there. It was just the best time. But the other women, the sister and the mother, sister-in-law and the mother, did not speak English. And yet, you know what? We all communicated just perfectly fine, perfectly well. They brought out all of their dresses and we all dressed up in their traditional style. We all laughed and we all just, you know, and again, we didn't speak the same language, but you don't have to. You will find a way to connect.
Totally.
And that is how you feel empowered, right? You have to have that connection with yourself first and be open and willing to do that. And then you start feeling that connection with others. And that's how you start feeling empowered, that you can make a difference in the world, that you find where you are aligned with your purpose, where you are living authentically, and that's where you are empowered yourself and where you're also able to empower others.
Yeah, it's true. Well, I've got an example where I had to get out of my comfort zone and feel empowered. I was on business in my previous life. I was working in sales, and I was in Norway or Sweden, but in Scandinavia. That was Valentine's Day, you know, and I had to go out for dinner. And I was just like, oh my God, going on my own with all those people, you know, having a fantastic time. And I just thought, but I've got no choice. I've got to go and eat. So so I just stopped. I took a deep breath thinking, well, they're just going to look at me, but it doesn't matter because I need to eat, you know. So I went there. Thank God that was a restaurant I had been several times before. And they found me a table, and I was on my own. And everybody turned around looking at me, and I just thought, well, they're probably going to think, oh, poor little one, she's on her own, and nobody's coming to have dinner with her. And after that, I just thought, yeah, but at the end of the day, I feel like, well, first I needed to eat, but, and so what if I'm on my own on Valentine's Day? But I felt confident enough to just go and look at those eyes staring at me, thinking, oh, poor little one, she's been dumped, or, and I was like, okay, confidence. I know I can do it. I trust myself to do it. And I did it. So yes. And I came out stronger, thinking, well, if it happens again, I know I can do it.
Absolutely. And kudos to you for doing that, taking that step outside of your comfort zone to try something. Well, I don't know if it was new, but something different. And you know what, Isabelle? What if all those people were sitting there? They're not thinking that poor little thing. They're thinking, what a brave woman that is, right? That's what I would be sitting there thinking, what a brave person that is to come out on their own on Valentine's Day to eat. And that gives you sort of a different feeling when you're walking in too, right? That you know that all these other people are there. They're there supporting you, thinking how brave you are. And so sometimes getting ourselves in the right mindset before we walk into a room is is the same thing, right? Because we all do that. We all make up stories about what other people might be thinking about us. And probably 98% of the time, it's not really true, right? I mean, how much of the time do I spend thinking about somebody else? Not really, right? I'm busy enjoying my own dinner or whatever it is. However, if it's the other way around, I think they're thinking about me, right? When in reality, they're probably not thinking about me at all. They're like enjoying their dinner and their spouse or whatever. And so just to put that in perspective, that before you walk in, you can walk in with all that confidence because you know that those people are thinking, what a brave person that is. And that's a different way to walk into it. So just shifting our perspective that little bit. You're walking into the same room. They have the same people there. You're dressed the same. You're eating the same, but you just have a whole different energy about you because of how you feel inside when you walk
in. Exactly. It's like feeling inside. I know that sometimes the first step is the most difficult one. Absolutely. But then when we've done it, that's it. It's just like no stopping back, no stopping and no coming, but going back.
Right. No going back. Yeah. Full steam ahead. So much. Yes. Yes. Well, I really appreciate that. And, you know, I just invite everyone listening today to consider, what is your inspiration? What is it that you look at? Who is it that you talk to, or maybe in real life or in your head, right? Maybe you have that person, whether it's real or imaginary or whatever, have that person that sort of builds your confidence for you, right? That you go to and have that conversation with before you go into that room all by yourself, right? maybe you imagine you're walking in with them. I don't know. Maybe whatever it takes for you to have that level of confidence for you to do that. It's okay to do that. And it's okay to surround ourselves with those people that are going to do that for us, that help us with that, right? That we either put that phone call out to, or they're the imaginary people in our lives that, now I'm not saying you have a whole slew of imaginary friends that keep you out of society. I'm not saying that, but sometimes we have to have those people with us that bring us that when there's when we're just in the moment and there's not somebody there by our side. So
definitely we need to be surrounded by positive people, because that will help us to change our mindset, mm-hmm. to be positive and just say, well, at the end of the day, what's the worst thing which can happen? That's always what I tell myself. Okay.
Yeah.
And what is the best thing? What is the magic thing? You know, what are you going to get out of it? So, and then suddenly I'm just like, yeah, I'm going to grow. It might not go the way I want, but maybe it's going to be better.
Yes. Yes. Right. So what else is possible? What else is possible?
Exactly. Right. Yeah. Looking at it in a different way, just like, why are we always thinking negative? Why couldn't it be positive and something magical will turn out of it? That's the way I tend to see it. So it's true. But surrounded by people who really are there for you, will be there to challenge you even, and to just say, but I know you can do it. So that's why I'm challenging you. Yeah. So because I know you've got it inside you, just because you don't know or you're scared, that could be.
Right. And we're all scared sometimes. Like, it's not about that, right? And it's, so I don't know if you, I listen to Wendy Palmer sometimes. She, I think she's 70 now. She has her own dojo and does leadership empowerment development speaking, but she always talks about being a little more noble, awesome, and shiny, right? So imagine yourself a little more noble, awesome, and shiny when you walk into something or when you're trying something new. And the more you do it, the more, like you said, the more you do it, then it's okay. The more you can do it. So the more you're willing to try new things, the more you're willing to try new things. It's that empowered feeling. And physically, your body knows that. It really does. When you're more willing to walk into a room full of strangers one time, your body will more easily do that the next time. You're not going to feel that tightness, that stress as much. I'm not going to say you're not going to feel it at all. You won't feel it as much because you have some of those tools to get through that. Maybe some of that deep breathing, maybe some of that looking out at all everyone out there, or putting your sight line at a farther sight distance out. All of those things are tools that help you to get there, to help you to do that, as long as that's what you want and as long as you take that first step. You have to know that's what you want. You have to be willing to take a step. You have to let go and let the universe bring it all to you, because God in the universe is out there having your back. And if you believe that, if you truly believe that, then you're much more willing and able to take that step.
True. It's true. And sometimes we are in a situation which doesn't turn out the way we want. And usually it's for the best. We don't know it straight away, but that's usually for the best, because looking back afterwards, just like, thank God it didn't happen.
Right? Yeah. I know. You can think of times in my own life when that has been so true. Like, you know, you wanted something and then it didn't happen. Later on, years later, you realize something so much better did. So
exactly. Another thing I do to get more confident as well, I do visualization, as you were saying, to imagine yourself. Yeah. Just like before walking into the room or doing something difficult for me, I just think, okay, I just close my eyes and I see myself entering that room or doing that difficult thing, and that I've done it. And I usually finish visualization with, yes, I've done it.
Yes, right? Yes, yes.
And it gives that power. Yeah. And I'm just like, of course, if I felt it, if I saw it in my visualization, I can do it.
Yeah, yeah. And now you just step into it. Yeah. Uh-huh. So, absolutely. Yeah, it's so helpful. Uh-huh. Well, it's been so nice talking with you today, Isabelle.
Wow. Thank you, Susan, for all those tips. So being the right mindset is like receiving, being in the moment, believe it, and looking at being inclusive.
Yes, yes.
Fantastic, that's great. So, Susan, thank you very much. But I know you've got something to tell us. You've got a workshop starting tomorrow, I think.
I do. So if you like empowered mindset and abundance mindset, There is a free workshop tomorrow, and it includes a free workbook. It's an hour each day on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. It's called ASK, and ASK is an acronym. A for abundance, all of it, right? We all want all of it. We want abundance in all those areas of our lives. S is the strategy. What's the strategy we need to get there? And then K is the knowledge. What is the knowledge that we need? What is the knowledge our clients need in order to come to us to receive what we are offering? So that's tomorrow at noon to 1 Central Standard Time.
Yeah.
And I would love to see anyone, all of you there. I invite you all to join me there. And we have a wonderful time. As you know, I love to have interactive conversation. So we'll have some interactive time as well. And then we always have some of those like tips to share and experiential learning along the way. So I invite you all there. If not, just reach out to me if you want to have a conversation, SusanEricksonCoaching.com. And I'd be happy to have a conversation at any time and see where that leads us. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Susan. And you will see in the description of this talk show, the link for the free webinar, for Susan's free webinar starting tomorrow. Don't forget. Thank you very much, Susan, for being here. And next week, my guest speaker will be Christian Massey from Hong Kong. And yes, we will be talking about fears of public speaking. Look at that. You see, we're going to create the mindset and then nothing to fear about.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
And if you have missed the previous talk shows, don't worry. Just look for my YouTube channel, Phoenix Coaching and Training. And I'm sure you'll find some interesting topics. And thank you to all the coaches who have been with me since April. And we will carry on next year anyway. And Susan, you're always welcome to come back. I'll see you all next Monday with Christian Massey from Hong Kong. So thank you again. Thank you, Susan. And I'll see you next week.